Hello students, we were speaking about the representative uses of the computer graphics. In this, the third part is what you are watching now. So that is visualization. So in the visualization, so what are the different types of visualization that we have? So scientific visualization, graphical representation for scientific engineering and medical data sets, and the scientists, engineers, medical personnel, business analysts all use this visualization for analyzing, for understanding, or for making the others understand. So this is called as the very prominent use of the computer graphics. So we'll see with example. That is, you can see this in the medical visualization. So in the medical visualization, the doctors, what they do is, so they take the help of this visualization, that is what is happening in the human body, that is getting the x-ray or doing the scan. So the doctor gets the clear picture of what has happened in the human body, and then that can be used for the diagnosis, and treatment can be done on the basis of this diagnosis, and the diagnosis becomes very apt, or it becomes very professional, so when it is visualized. And also to make the other medical students understand about the conditions of the human body, so this can be used also. And the scientific visualization, so there in this next slide you can see any virus that has attacked the human body, and all the different other antibodies that are getting created in the human body. So all these types of things can be understood very well with the help of this whole concept of the computer graphics, where we are looking into the visualization. So whatever the concept we have, that is in the pen and paper, whatever you write it down, you give the description of how the virus will look like. So now you must have seen in the example of this coronavirus thing, so how the coronavirus is looking like, so it is visualized and it is shown to us in the televisions, and how it is done. So it is done with the help of the graphics. So when the doctors or when the scientists give the description of how the virus will look like, so how will be its nature, or how will be its feature, so using that, the computer graphics program visualizes it, and it comes to a layman in term of a beautiful picture which is visualized, and the layman can also understand what it is, that is how it is visualized. Only with the theoretical parts, so a layman cannot understand what is the real concept of this. So this is what the scientific visualization is. And then next is the image processing. Image processing is it is something like modifying or interpret the existing image. So you do modification to the images, that is what we call it as the image processing. That is processing in the sense image is getting processed as per the user's input. And there you can see in beside of a building, so there was maybe a person is standing, and you can make the person look a very huger even than the building, and that is done with the help of image processing. So image processing has different examples in our day-to-day life, and that is image enhancement, law enforcement, medical, and the moving object tracking. So that we shall see one by one. And then image enhancement, so there you can see x-ray is being captured, and then that x-ray or the image whichever is captured, so it has noise. So noise in the sense, noise is not only related to the sound. So in the digital thing, so any unwanted thing, any extra unwanted thing which is disturbing the whole data, you call it as a noise. So therefore here the noise is removed, and then the x-ray is made to look more clear. That is, we have enhanced the quality of the image. So like this we can use the graphics for enhancement of the image. And then the law enforcement, so number plate is recognized, or the fingerprint is recognized when the criminals can be caught easily with the help of these recognition techniques. And next is the medical field. So in this medical field, as we see, the x-rays or ultraviolet sounds whichever are used, so the image processing uses it to diagnose the diseases. Moving object tracking is one example of image enhancement, where the measure of the motion of the object is captured, and then the gesture of the particular person or animal or anything is captured. So it will be very helpful. So when we consider the computer graphics which is used, that is the image processing which is used in the crime diagnosing, so that is the medical diagnosing, so in all that the moving object tracking is used. And next is the graphical user interface. So it is the very best example of, you can see that the graphical user interface is one which has made the computers to be so very popular among anybody who is not so technical person of the computers. So that is, even the person has not studied the computers, so even is not so literate, so even then, so the person can use a computer. So say take an example of going into an ATM machine. So whenever you go to an ATM machine, so everything is so very easily visible to you. It gives you instructions, you touch the screen, you press the button, you press the password and all that, and you just follow the instructions whatever is going on. So all that because of this graphical user interface. Because graphical user interface, in the sense, it is the interface between the computer and the user. So it acts as a middleman between the computer and the user. So because computer understands only very technical commands and all those, and the layman can't use the technical commands, so you can just give the command with the help of this touch, with the help of the click, and all that is because of this graphical user interface. Because the screen is so clearly visible, and using that I can just click on it, I can just drag and drop, and I can touch the device, touch the screen, and then get the task done. So that is, commands are given through the touch, through the click. And that is the very best example of the computer graphics which is being used by a layman. Okay, and then the computer graphics so popular, and it has become a part and parcel of everybody's life because the layman can use it. So because the layman can use, and they can take the help of it, and they can use the computers, use the ATM cards, use the smartphones, everything, so without much technical commands, and all that is because of this graphical user interface. So in all these part 1, 2 and 3, so we have seen the representative uses of the computer graphics. Go through all these three parts, only then you can have the clear look of the representative uses. In the next concept, we'll go on with the algorithms and the other aspects. Thank you.